We're going to go to our newsmaker line and say good morning to the borough manager of Clarion. And on the line is Nancy Freenock. Nancy, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. And I would just preface that by saying the former borough manager of Clarion Borough.
Oh, the former borough. Okay.
Former borough manager.
That's right.
So you are new. Now, it was never resolved. I mean, we're still where we were on Tuesday night?
Yes. The borough has no manager. At this point, it has no ability to issue any kind of checks. There is no secretary treasurer, so operations are basically at a standstill.
Now, Nancy, what happened, and I know that Andrea Eastad is also with you, who is the former mayor.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Andrea. How are you? Welcome to our program down here in chilly Norristown, Pennsylvania.
Well, thank you very much. I'm glad to be on it.
And we're glad to have you because this story, we're going to make this a national story.
It's we're going to try and make it a national story because it was one of the most poorly planned power grabs I've ever seen in my life. And thank God for YouTube so that can be captured for posterity. Nancy, can you walk us through a little bit of what happened during the reorg meeting that set up the non-renewal of your contract during the business meeting? Because as some people don't know, there's two separate meetings. There's a reorg meeting, which is required by law at the beginning of the year, where you appoint all of your township officials and create your chairman and your vice chairman and everything else. And then there's the regular business meeting. So
That's
if you
correct.
Could just, you know, walk us through a little bit of what happened in the meeting before the meeting we see on this YouTube video.
Okay, if I could just preface this, because I did listen last night on the internet to your show. In a borough, the council is comprised of seven members.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we had five present at that meeting, one having been elected who was not available for the meeting, another one who had to resign by the end of the year because she was elected to a county position.
Okay.
Okay.
So we had five people, and also in a borough, the mayor is only permitted to vote in case of a tie, and it's a weak mayor, strong council setup.
Okay.
What happened at the reorganization meeting was that the new members of council were seated. There were only two. There should have been three. They were seated. The president of council was elected, who was Mr. Walters, who you see in the video, sitting next to me, and mm-hmm. I'm identified in the video.
Mm-hmm.
Then there was a vote for vice president. They actually elected the council person who was not seated to the vice presidency, which she could not be elected to that position because she wasn't a sitting council person at the time.
Mm-hmm.
They went ahead and elected her, just so you're aware.
Yes.
Okay.
Then they elected the president pro tem, then the newly elected president of council took over the meeting from Mayor Eastad, and he proceeded to say that he was tabling the remainder of the appointments on the agenda, which were for the borough secretary, the borough treasurer, the borough manager, and the borough solicitor.
Mm-hmm.
And he said he wanted to table them because he needed time to consider. I don't really know.
There really wasn't a good explanation given, if I can interrupt it.
Yeah.
It was not a good explanation, and it basically started us all on a tailspin downward. We just didn't know we were heading there.
And so one of the key things about that is you went into the business meeting without a solicitor.
That's correct.
Yeah. So yeah. Then
because they kept asking the solicitor for advice, and he said, "I'm not the solicitor." Yeah, that was in the video, which was an amazing point. But he remained at the table. Did he stay at the table for any reason?
I think what he said on the video and what I recall him saying is, I am sitting here now as a courtesy.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Yeah, because he was not ready to give any advice at that point. So
that's correct.
So the vote went through, and Mr. Noto and Ms. Deedy.
Data.
Both of them seemed, both of them were clearly outraged because following, I saw Mr. Noto was the first one to start sliding out his name tag.
Yeah, what did we do, he's saying?
Well, I have to tell you, that there's a good portion of the video that's missing.
Okay.
That leads up to this point. So, first of all, Mr. Walters did not get a motion for tabling.
Okay.
He just went ahead and tabled it. So Robert's Rules of Order were not really present at this meeting. And on top of that, I think that with Jason and Brenda, they don't have to really keep me in the loop. As Nancy said, it's a weak mayor, strong council system. But the biggest thing of all of this was the lack of respect from the other three members of council.
Mm-hmm.
to inform them what their agenda was. I mean, I think we all had an idea that, you know, of what they were planning on doing. We didn't think it was happening last night. We didn't, or 2 nights ago. We didn't think it was going to be done in the fashion that it was done, especially as unprofessional as it was.
Right.
We had it. He was making motions and seconding them, not realizing he was unable to do so. The meeting was run extremely poorly, so there was a lot of chaos to begin with. So after you table all of these positions, I think I can only speak for myself. I was under the assumption that the contract would just be approved because we need someone to run.
Right.
Nancy would then take over, and then at the next meeting they would reorganize, and whoever they would hire, whether it be her or someone else, you know, you just would move forward.
But so yeah,
it was just a blind side. And so, I looked at Brenda and Jason, and they were completely astonished by that.
7:42 is our time. We're News Talk 1180 WFYL, Barry and Lisa in the morning. And we have on the phone the former borough manager of Clarion, Pennsylvania. And that is Nancy. Say it
Freenock.
Again. Freenock.
Freenock.
Okay.
Freenock.
I can't read my own writing. I'm sorry, Nancy.
Okay.
And the former mayor, Andrea Eastat. And they are trying to clarify the little earthquake that happened in their borough the other night, which has been captured on YouTube. And the other day when I looked at it, it had 300 hits. And now it has 3,581 hits.
Yes.
So people,
actually, it has over 4,200. I just looked this morning.
It had 35 at 7 o'clock, so this thing's starting to go viral. Here we go, ladies. This is how it happens. Can you Sean Hannity?
Yeah.
I think the very sad thing is that it was clear that they had no plan of succession.
And that's the thing that is amazing to me, because not only did they not renew your contract, knowing probably full well that that was going to be it for you, but now they have no plan of succession. But I mean, it comes down to the fact that they really can't even cut checks today.
That's
at this point in time, because you're the one who signs the checks. I mean, you're the one who runs the township. So, you know, if you're not in that office, they cannot use your signature to sign these checks. And right now, there's nobody who's authorized to do that. Is that correct?
Right. That's correct.
Is Friday payday in the
Monday is payday.
Monday. Monday's going to be a pretty interesting day.
Well, from what I understand, they've organized a special meeting to be held tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. And Mr. Walter's reason that was quoted on the, or it was him speaking to the radio reporter after the meeting, said that he felt that the contract was not in the best interest of the taxpayers.
Hmm.
I also think that it's not in the best interest of the taxpayers to take an action like this without foreseeing the consequences.
No, clearly it was, like I said, the most ham-handed and awkward attempt, awkward power grab I think I've ever seen. And like I said, we're no strangers to this. We live in Montgomery County.
Yeah. Right.
A lot of shenanigans down here. Nancy, how long have you been the borough manager in Clarion?
6 years.
6 years. Did you have any idea that this was about to happen at the meeting on Tuesday night?
I did not know for sure that it was going to happen on Tuesday night. Mr. Walters told me a year and a half ago that the reason that he ran for council was to get me fired.
Wow.
So I've been living with that for, you know, a year and a half. So
wow.
I knew that once he was in power that something was going to happen to my position. I just didn't know what or when. And I made no secret of that. When we were doing the budget this year, for this year, I increased legal fees substantially, and I was asked by Mr. Walters or someone, I believe it was Mr. Walters, why I did that. And I'm not sure that you're aware of this, but I'm a licensed attorney.
Uh-huh.
And I do a great deal of legal work for the borough that is blessed by the solicitor. I never acted as the borough solicitor, but I wrote ordinances and resolutions and reviewed contracts and did things like that to save the borough money. This move is not going to save the borough money. I have to pay the solicitor to do the tasks that I did.
Mm-hmm.
And it won't be Mr. French who has said he does not want to be reappointed.
That's correct.
In the wake of this this ridiculousness that happened on Tuesday night.
That's correct.
Nancy, do you feel comfortable talking about what it is that Mr. Walters had a problem with you about?
I have to tell you that it's hearsay, but what I have been told is that something that I did when I was a green borough manager enraged him to the point that was the reason why he ran. When I became borough manager, the borough was essentially bankrupt.
Mm-hmm.
It did not have the funds to pay its bills.
Wow.
And along with that, I was told, and by the way, our fire hall is in desperate need of repair. You need to find a way to fix it.
Oh.
the only way that I could find to fix it, because we didn't have the money, the borough did not have the money, was to get a grant. And I found a grant that I could apply for, but I needed an architectural study.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, being in government, nobody gives anything to the government for free.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So I had to find someone that would do the study for me and get a price. And the price was about $2,500. I didn't have $2,500 anywhere in the budget for such a study. So I went to council and I asked if I could use some of the fire millage. And I was told yes. My mistake was in not realizing that I should have gone to the fire company and explained this. I did try. I was unsuccessful in reaching them, and I just figured, oh, it's not that important. That was my mistake.
Mm-hmm.
The fire company was upset. They came to a council meeting, and council said, oh, we misunderstood, and Nancy, you can't use the money for that. You have to pay them the fire millage. Now, my suggestion was an appropriate use of the fire millage, because that millage can be used for anything associated with the fire company.
Right.
But again, I should have gone to the fire company and asked if they would agree to this. That was absolutely a mistake on my part. But
you tried to fix it.
I did.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't
That's the thing. She tried to fix it.
It sounds like quite a bit of an overreaction and almost a childish grudge that's being held here for somebody who is trying to do the best thing for the fire company.
Well, and I think what part is missing here, but I think we can all assume, Mr. Walters is a volunteer fireman.
I was just going to ask that. That was my next question. Boy, they take that,
now,
they take it seriously.
Prior to me becoming mayor, I had heard the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
After becoming mayor, I was actually at a wedding where I was told by him his plan.
Wow.
His course of action.
And
I think the other two pieces that are missing here is that the other two council members also have issues with Nancy, one involving arbitration with the police department over a contract, and the other over a gentleman not getting a public works position.
Oh.
Both of them